Hello. Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to the course Psychology of Learning, Programming Life Wellness. In brief, we will explore the following topics: the nature of learning, the dynamics of learning, and the goal of learning. Enjoy.
Blah blah blah. Do you understand the equation, children? Blah blah blah. Hey. Do you understand the lesson, children? Okay. I guess you understand.
Kinda, teacher, blah blah blah.
I'm tired and hungry, teacher. Let us go home.
OMG. I thought teaching is easy. How will I manage the learning of these children?
Learning happens because of the brain, sensory, and memory.
Why do my students behave differently?
Okay. Simple. The dynamics of their brain, memory, sensory are different from each other. Before you meet each of them, their brain, sensory, and memory have been programmed already.
Does it mean I cannot do anything anymore? Because they were programmed already?
You can still do a lot of things for them. We call that reprogram. You have to plan, implement, and evaluate your lessons very well to focus on specific area of their development.
Okay. It means I am dealing with different brains, sensories, and memories here. Wow, this is a tough work. I have to discover each of them. This needs a serious planning.
Learning is about the stimulation, processing, and programming of the brain, sensory, and memory.
I have done all games, fun activities, and reward system. But the children are not paying attention to me. What else do I need to understand about the brain, sensory, and memory? Hi doctor. Help me understand better the dynamics of learning. The diversity of children's brain, sensory, and memory is a challenging issue here. Help me doctor, please.
Learning is basically about connecting with and controlling the object of learning through stimulation, processing, and programming. Yes. To learn is to connect and control. When you teach, you stimulate, process, and you program the brain, sensory, and memory. At the same time, your students are stimulated, do the processing, and build programs. These are the questions you have to ask. What are the activities that can help stimulate, process, and program learning? The quality of the child's responses to stimulation, processing, and programming will depend on the capacity, potential, and limitation of the brain, sensory, and memory.
Now I understand. That is the reason why some kids are fast and others are slow. Each of them would respond differently in learning activities. I have to reflect on my methodology.
The challenge now is to be aware on how each of those minds responds to your stimulation, processing, and programming. Not easy, but that is the way to shape the mind.
What is the goal of learning? Why do we need to learn?
Learning is about wellness. Curriculum is only a tool. We teach children so that they will learn how to choose wellness.
I will use math, science, language, and other subjects to shape their wellness. The curriculum has to focus in shaping the wellness. Wellness is the core of learning.
You are right. You help children shape their physical, emotional, social, cognitive, communication, environmental, and spiritual wellness. Use the subjects to highlight wellness.
I will use my lesson to program their brain, sensory, and memory for wellness. Wellness is my ultimate goal for teaching. It is not only about the curriculum. It is about life.
For wellness.
This is one way of actualizing wellness. It is a way of life. I should be a model of wellness to my students. I breathe wellness. I celebrate the wellness of my students.
You can do it, teacher. 3, 2, 1, yehi. 100 push-ups, teacher.
Hello, beautiful people. What do you want to do today? Is everybody okay? Tell me. I will listen to each of you. How do we start the class in a happy and positive way? I want to dance, teacher. Well, it is not easy. But guided by the wellness framework, I will be able to journey with my students positively and productively. With wellness as my path, teaching will be fun.